fields, private investors are also allowed. Joint venture abroad to encash on, to increase liquidation of our capacity of chemical fertilizer with buyback arrangement. And the other two, fertilizer monitoring system and nutrient-based subsidy. Quickly trying to take up your questions. I'm done with chemical industries before I take you to the next industry. Any question coming up in your brain, you can quickly ask me. I'll answer that, and I hope you are taking understanding of what we are trying to learn. Chemical fertilizer, the important constituent of chemical industries in the country, incorporate the constituents that is dominantly public sector. Cooperative players are also significant, specifically in the joint venture abroad. And we incorporate new fertilizer policy with 5-point references. So no questions from your side. I'm going back to the screen share. Okay, we take the reference of our next important sector. And that next important sector of industry in the chemical category. The pharmaceutical industries is also specifically mentioned in our syllabus, so we need to take note of it. And in the present times of pandemic, we have actually noticed that India have come up as a forefront player when it comes to the chemical, the pharmaceuticals, the formulations or the bulk drugs. And it has been a very consistent kind of development in the country because we noticed the genesis of pharmaceutical from the colonial time itself. So if I start with pharmaceutical industry, conventional frame of starting, I'll say, when is the genesis of this industry? So colonial times. With bulk drugs imported and processing done in the centers like then Kolkata and Bombay, Kolkata and Mumbai. So we had genesis of pharmaceutical industries since the colonial time. So it will be wrong for me to say that we never had the genesis of pharmaceutical in the colonial time period. But what you need to understand logically is that whenever we take reference of pharmaceutical industries and its growth, it is post-independence that the growth have been much more dominant. So genesis may be colonial time, but real growth is post-independence. And post-independence under Department of Chemicals, we take reference of the development of pharmaceutical industry. Give me a minute, please. So real growth post independence. However, genesis we certainly can see during the colonial time, as I mentioned. Whenever we talk about this industry, we do put it into the category at par with fertilizer and chemical industry, but it certainly has got point of difference to it. What is the locational characteristics of it? So conventional part two, locational characteristics. It's essentially market oriented. And remember one thing, 4 + 3, easier way to remember, 4 + 3 cities. And 4 + 3 cities, I'm not essentially talking about it as 5, I'm talking about 4 + 3 because it becomes easier for us. So Delhi, Mumbai, Chennai, Kolkata, 4 plus Kanpur, Vadodara, and Hyderabad. Registers maximum concentration of pharmaceutical production capacity in the country. Is it only market oriented? No, but if I just compare the capacity built up, maximum is market oriented. So compared to other chemical industry that we have talked about already, chemical fertilizer, I can have a comparative say. I'll say pharmaceutical industries are more market oriented. So market oriented as dominant characteristics, don't take it as only characteristics. Producers. Public sector enterprises. It's big bulk. Hindustan Antibiotic Limited. Functioning plant at Pimpri. And joint venture companies. Let me create a table sort of this. Okay, this will be more helpful. The joint venture company, joint venture, state governments will have their stake. It remains public sector player with union and state government share. So joint venture companies includes Maharashtra Antibiotic and Pharmaceutical Limited. Karnataka Antibiotic and Pharmaceutical Limited and Manipur States Drugs and Pharmaceutical Limited. This is how your map practice goes. I'm otherwise not talking about Imphal that easily. I do talk about Nagpur. Nagpur for oranges. Nagpur that is essentially considered to be mini Mumbai. Nagpur which is coming up with the expressway, new expressway, National Highway 6 which will be connecting it to the hinterland of Mumbai. And Nagpur is also with MAPL, MAPL, Maharashtra Antibiotic and Pharmaceutical Limited. So I've got four plans for HAL, Hindustan Antibiotic Limited. Now I write again IDPL. Indian Drugs and Pharmaceutical Limited. 1957 HAL was commissioned. 1961 we had IDPL commissioned. IDPL any day is a bigger player. IDPL has got functioning plants in Rishikesh, Gurugram, Hyderabad. It has got IDPL Tamil Nadu in Chennai. Bihar Drugs and Chemicals Limited. And then when I come to the joint venture companies, it has got joint venture companies including ODCL, Bhubaneswar, and you can easily decode it, ODCL, if it is Bhubaneswar, try to make it, Odisha Drugs and Chemicals Limited, so it becomes easier for you to take, and RDPL, Rajasthan Drugs and Pharmaceutical Limited in Jaipur. Bengal Chemicals and Pharmaceutical Limited, Kolkata, Mumbai, Kanpur. Bengal Immunity Limited, and Smith Stanley Street. Why I have put on a star mark to these players, let me just zoom it out so that all is visible. All these producers are in public sector category. And why I have put on a star mark with BCPL, Bengal Chemicals and Pharmaceutical, BIL, Bengal Immunity and SSL, Smith Stanley Street, because unlike HAL and unlike IDPL, these three players are in production of chemicals, pharmaceuticals, chemicals that includes industrial chemicals, domestic chemicals, cosmetic chemicals, so big range. So they are not exclusively for pharmaceutical, but are counted among the public sector there. So which are the major producers of pharmaceutical in the country? It is IDPL, HAL, along with other three public sector players. Right? Copy down. And then if I have to take reference of, I'll just remove the bottom. And if I have to talk about the private players, which have been essentially exponential with their growth post 2002, I'll talk about policy initiatives after a while. So the big names that I can include is Cipla, Ranbaxy, Orchid Chemicals, Biocon, Dabur Pharma, Matrix Lab, to name some. And I purposefully named them because we have to learn some of the policy factors and challenges that are related to this sector. And where are they located? We have already counted 4 + 3 cities. They are essentially located with market-oriented. We are not left out with time to talk about policy initiative of pharmaceuticals. So I quickly repeat what we have learned, and I missed out on a point, so I'll be talking about that also quickly. With pharmaceuticals, we have learned that the genesis of pharmaceuticals was in the colonial time itself. However, the true growth have been registered post-independence. 1957, when we had commissioning of Hindustan Antibiotic Limited. Chemical fertilizer in comparison had its beginning in 1951. There was no genesis of chemical fertilizer in colonial times. When it comes to pharmaceuticals, we have got big range of private players now. There is no exaggeration in saying that India as a major pharmaceutical player in the world today is essentially the participation of private player rather than public sector. But the public sector player do continues to have their dominant say in the essential drugs and life-saving drugs, etc. So we cannot minimize their importance. This much we have learned about pharmaceutical, not much. I'll be repeating it again tomorrow. What we have learned with chemical fertilizer is that it still remains in the domain of public sector player, and that there has been immense sickness that got evolved because we supplemented price retention scheme by urea procurement system, and that has been reason that there has been the shutting down of the industry. The 5-point new industrial policy has to be taken into consideration. Best way to consolidate, these are the problems and these are the factors. What I missed out there. So you are looking in for the class notes, the handwritten notes of the previous batch. Okay, I'll be mailing those handwritten notes of the portion that we are covering so that you can take an easy reference of it. Otherwise, I'm almost writing everything and I think we are understanding the things well. Any other question? Got the understanding? New mode of learning? Threefold financial burden is not clear. Puri class repeat karni padegi mujhe. Financial burden in the old policy includes, number one, give annual subsidy. Number two, compensate the difference between the price and the cost. And number three, provide subsidy to the farmers. provide subsidy to the farmers is the third one. कैसी लग रही है इस तरह से क्लास? मुझे तो लगता है मैं अपने आप को ही पढ़ा रही हूँ, बिकॉज आई कैन सी माई सेल्फ ओनली. चलो फटाफट अपना अपना कैमरा ऑन करो, आप लोगों को देखें क्विकली बिफोर आई बिड यू गुड बाय.